This is the revelation of Jesus Christ, which God gave him, so that he might show his servants what must soon take place. He made it known by sending his angel to his servant John, who, in telling all that he saw, has borne witness to the word of God and to the testimony of Jesus Christ. Happy is the one who reads aloud the words of this prophecy, and happy are those who listen, for the time of fulfillment is near. John, to the seven churches in the province of Asia, grace to you and peace from Jesus Christ, the firstborn from the dead and ruler of the kings of the earth. To him who loves us and has set us free from our sins with his blood, to him be glory and dominion forever. Amen. I, John, your brother, who share with you in the suffering, the sovereignty, and the endurance which are ours in Jesus, was on the island called Patmos. On the Lord's day, the Spirit came upon me, and I heard behind me a loud voice like the sound of a trumpet, which said, "Write down in a book what you see, and send it to the seven churches, to Ephesus, Smyrna, Pergamum, Thyatira, Sardis, Philadelphia, and Laodicea." I turned to see whose voice it was who spoke to me, and when I turned, I saw a figure like a man in a robe that came to his feet with a golden girdle round his breast. His hair was as white as snow-white wool, and his eyes flamed like fire. His voice was like the sound of a mighty torrent, and from his mouth came a sharp two-edged sword. His face shone like the sun in full strength. When I saw him, I fell at his feet as though I were dead. But he laid his right hand on me and said, "Do not be afraid. I am the first and last, and I am the living one. I was dead, and now I am alive forevermore, and I hold the keys of death and Hades. Write down, therefore, what you have seen, what is now, and what is to take place hereafter. To the angel of the church at Ephesus write, I know what you are doing, how you toil and endure. I know you cannot abide wicked people. You have put to the test those who claim to be apostles but are not, and you have found them to be false. You have borne up in my cause and have never become weary. However, I have this against you. The love you felt at first, you have now lost. Think from what a height you have fallen. Repent and do as once you did. You have ears, so hear what the Spirit says to the churches. To those who are victorious, I will give the right to eat from the tree of life that stands in the garden of God. To the angel of the church at Smyrna write, These are the words of the first and the last, who was dead and came to life again. I know how hard-pressed and poor you are, but in reality you are rich. Do not be afraid of the sufferings to come. Be faithful till death, and I will give you the crown of life. You have ears, so hear what the Spirit says to the churches. Those who are victorious cannot be harmed by the second death. To the angel of the church at Pergamum write, These are the words of the one who has the sharp two-edged sword. I know where you live. It is where Satan is enthroned. Yet you are holding fast to my cause. But you have in Pergamum some who put temptation in the way of the Israelites, to eat food sacrificed to idols and commit fornication. Repent! If you do not, I will come to you quickly and make war on them with the sword that comes out of my mouth. You have ears, so hear what the Spirit says to the churches. To the angel of the church at Thyatira write, These are the words of the Son of God, whose eyes flame like fire. I know what you are doing, your love and faithfulness, your service and your endurance. But I have this against you. You tolerate that Jezebel, the woman who claims to be a prophetess, whose teaching lures my servants into fornication and into eating food sacrificed to idols. I have given her time to repent, but she refuses. So I will throw her on a bed of pain, and I will plunge her lovers into terrible suffering, and her children I will kill with pestilence. This will teach all the churches that I am the searcher of men's hearts and minds, and that I will give to each of you what his deeds deserve. And now I speak to the rest of you in Thyatira, who have had no experience of what they call the deep secrets of Satan. Hold fast to what you have until I come. To him who perseveres in doing my will to the end, I will give authority over the nations, that same authority which I received from my father, and he will rule them with a rod of iron, smashing them to pieces like earthenware, and I will give him the star of dawn. You have ears, so hear what the Spirit says to the churches. To the angel of the church at Sardis, write, I know what you are doing. People say you are alive, but in fact you are dead. Wake up and put some strength into what you still have, because otherwise it must die. For I have not found any work of yours brought to completion in the sight of God. Remember, therefore, the teaching you received. Observe it and repent. If you do not wake up, I will come upon you like a thief, and you will not know the moment of my coming. Yet you have a few people in Sardis.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.